So, let's begin with segment 2 of operating in the courts of heaven, and I begin with this powerful verse in Hebrews chapter 6. Look at this. Therefore, leaving the basic principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on to perfection or maturity, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works, of faith towards God, doctrine of baptisms, please take note, S. There are at least 5 baptisms in the Bible. We know of only 1, water baptism. But there's also the baptism of the Holy Spirit. There's also bridal baptism. There's also baptism of fire. So, and of laying on of hands and resurrection of the dead and of eternal judgment. And this we will do if God permit. What is the writer of Hebrews saying? If we are just studying about repentance, faith, baptisms, laying on of hands, resurrection of the dead, eternal judgment, these are the basic principles of the doctrine of Christ. Some Bible versions interpret it as elementary. And the apostle Paul, who I suspect is the writer of the book of Hebrews, says, let us move on, let us go on to perfection, go to higher things. What are those higher things that are mentioned? It is hinted here. For it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gift and were made partakers of the Holy Spirit and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come. Powers of the world to come is part of the next course outline of the journey of the believer of Yeshua. Hindi lang ni doktrina, hindi lang doctrine. Doctrine is basic principle or elementary. You move on from doctrine to experience. What will I experience? The good word of God. Not just understand it as a doctrine, but taste it. Have you tasted the word? The word says, in him we live and move and have our being. Have we tasted that? The word says, God is the healer. Have we tasted that? Hindi lang ni doctrine, taste good. And the powers of the coming age, the world to come. Teleportation, translocation, interdimensional operation. But Brother Lindon, hindi ka na nagkuha na yung mga teleportation, transportation, translocation, interdimensional move. Di hindi bala nga gina ordinaryo lang na ni Philip. Hindi bala si Philip, ari di siya, karon at tuto siya. Hindi bala nga si Paul ato na sa third heaven. Hindi bala nga si Agabus, kabalo na siya sang butang antes pa matabo. That is tasting the powers of the world to come. We need to establish this because the things that we are discussing here is for Christians who are hungry for things beyond the basic elementary principles. If we want the basic elementary principles, we can go back to the usual lectures and conferences and seminars and doctrines. But going on to perfection, this we will do, God permitting, is tasting the powers of the world to come. So, ini nga lecture ni, tiribli ni, para ni sa mga gutom, kagusto, mag-taste sang powers of the world to come. But there is a warning. If you have once been enlightened, and may I make this personal, here in Nihop, if you have tasted of the heavenly gift here in Nihop, what are those things? You have silver dust, gold dust, visions, You have been made partakers of the Holy Ghost. You have tasted of the good word of God. You have experienced some of the powers of the world to come. If you fall away, I speak to you, Nihok, in the name of Yeshua. Be careful that none of you will fall away, especially on the ground of offenses. Matake off na ni, nagsunggod naman, kag nag-hurt naman, kay may amo naman na, kag amo naman na. Gadugo ang tagipusoon ko. Kagadugo ang tagipusoon sang Diyos. So, let's be careful about falling away. Let's also be careful that we do not cause the falling away of other people. You read the rest of Hebrews chapter 6 because that's not really my main topic tonight. I'm just telling you, telling us, by the authority of God's word, that we can taste the powers of the world to come, but we be careful that we do not fall away. Important foreword. The lesson that follows is wonderfully complex. Shift to heavenly mode. Don't stay in earthly mode. In order to appreciate the lesson that we are taking up, remember, because we are going to talk about heaven, heaven is multidimensional, meaning things happen in sequence but also at the same time. I thought that it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After 1 is 2, after 2 is 3. No, 1 is happening but 7 is also happening and 3 is also happening, but it is also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is sequential but also simultaneous. That's just how heaven is. Malingin ni karon ang ulo ta. Kun ay abi ko wala pato na tapos nga ang ato na tuhaw. Abi ko ga istorya pa siya, ti mahulat ko anay. Hindi ah, pa istorya ha siya sa Dios kag ikaw istorya man. Kay ga istorya na siya. Sila ang council nga pamati sa imo ga pamati man na sila sa Russia. Amo man to sala Indostan kag sa Pakistan kag sa Kyrgyzstan kag sa Mindoro, may gapangamuyo man to, gapamati man na to sila. At the same time, multidimensional ang heaven. Di last year nagpamati man na sila 2016 kag 2017, gasigi na sila pamati. Pero gadungan man na sila pamati kay wala man na to time. So that's just how it is. And please take note that the heavenly court attends to this case but also attends to another, and they are all happening at the same time. Okay. So, this is really fantastic. Now, before we learn how to operate in the courts of heaven, we better be familiar with the structure of heaven. A functioning understanding of what heaven is like. In the book 40 Days in Heaven, there are details that are fantastic. Other people who have gone up to heaven, I read one author who divided heaven into 7 compartments. The third heaven that he calls is divided into 7 compartments. My heaven of heavens, my etc. I'll not venture into that. Terribly na gina ka katahom. Pero diri lang kuya sa Bible mas start. Then let the Lord take you on your own journey to discover. Heaven is revealed to have 5 compartments or sections. There is a paradise. There is a city of God. There is a temple in heaven. There is somewhere in heaven a throne room, also known as the court. And there is this beautiful place called my Father's house, where many Christians and believers on earth are struggling to secure titles in the Father's house to be as near as possible to the throne of God. I just found out that some martyrs, they went to their deaths praying, Lord, I do not care. Just put my house near your throne in the Father's house. So, let's go over this one by one. Paradise. Jesus said to the criminal crucified next to him when he was crucified, "Truly, I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." And Paul in 2 Corinthians said he was caught up to paradise, although he says third heaven, but he specifies paradise. And then in Revelations 2:7, the Apostle John the Beloved gave this very important clue. "To the one who is victorious, I will give the right to eat from the tree of life which is in the paradise of God." In paradise, there is that tree of life. And true enough, the word paradise is from a root word, both Hebrew and Ugaritic in origin, meaning pleasure garden, a garden of lovers, a garden made by a groom for him to spend romantic times with her bride. That is the meaning of the word paradise. And in heaven, there is a garden. It is called paradise. And in heaven is a city. A city. Revelation 22 says, "No longer will there be any curse. The throne of God and of the Lamb will be in the city. In that city, there is no more night. They will not need the light of a lamp or the light of the sun, for the Lord will give them light." And so it looks like this. The best way that artists can try to comprehend it, although it is severely inadequate. This is paradise and there is the city. So when you go to heaven, and some of our loved ones, before they die, they have a wonderful picture of something beyond. There's a river, there are flowers, they are looking at paradise. But some have glimpses of the city. And this city, this holy city, is called the New Jerusalem. Okay? And there is, when John was carried by the Spirit to a great and high mountain, the Spirit showed him the holy city. Ining a city, may dimension gini, physical gini siya. Not physical, earthly physical, but it has a spiritual composition. That's another dimension. This city is so great. It has high wall. It has 12 gates, 3 gates on the east, 3 gates on the north, 3 gates on the south. It's a real city. It has 12 foundations, and on them the 12 names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. And the city is laid out as a square. Actually, in Hebrew, the word there is cube. Cube. For some reason, the genius of the architectural mind of God designed the holy city to be a cube. Butch probably will be better in explaining why it is a cube. But the material of the city's wall is jasper, while the city was pure gold, clear as glass. So if some of you have visions and dreams that you were walking in a street of gold, you are not in paradise, you are in the city of God, in heaven. Something is happening in the city and something is happening in paradise. There is a reason why people land in paradise. There is a